Al llegar al Tennessee Central Railway Museum, ubicado en Nashville, Estados Unidos, tuve la oportunidad de realizar una visita guiada que me permitió explorar a fondo la rica historia de los ferrocarriles en Estados Unidos. Después de mi llegada, el personal del Tennessee Central Railway Museum nos guió a través de cada aspecto de la historia de los ferrocarriles en Estados Unidos.
This here is a quarter-inch shell model of Union Station downtown. In years past, 20 trains a day left this station for towns all over the southeast. The last inner-city passenger train to Nashville was in 1979. After that, it was canceled by then-President Jimmy Carter. There's been efforts over the years to bring Amtrak back to Nashville, but at least so far, that hasn't happened yet. Nashville does have a passenger train. It's a commuter train that runs from Riverfront Station, which is down on the bank of the Tennessee River, out to Lebanon and back, and there's about, I want to say, six stops in between. It uses old Chicago Metro equipment that we bought for $1. Really, we did. The cars were about to be scrapped, and they offered them to us for $1, and so we brought them down and refurbished them, and we run those together with Amtrak locomotives, F40s that are former Amtrak engines. This building that you're in was the master mechanic's warehouse and office. He kept parts for all of the locomotives and cars that came in off of the Tennessee Central. Of course, you can see they were big into Alco locomotives. That warehouse was over close to the Sullivan Evans Bridge. You can see it in the background here in this picture, and it burned down back in the early 70s, 1971, I think, that's right. If you want to step in here and look at our HO layout, Central, this card that you see here, I have one of those in my collection. When Senator Howard Baker was running for re-election back in 1972, he had a campaign train made up to carry him around the state, and he could make campaign speeches off the back of the train. And on the front of the train, he had this old steam engine. It's not real large as steam engines go. It's a little 10-wheeler, and it had a diesel assist on it. But still, it was nice. It did a good job. The other things that are in the cabinet are HO scale models of the Tennessee Central passenger and freight trains that came through here. The Tennessee Central ran from Hopkinsville, Kentucky, through Nashville and on over to Harriman, Tennessee, where it interchanged with the Southern Railway. In this cabinet here, these are O scale models. It's 1/4 inch to the foot, or 1/48 proportion to the prototype. These are models that of trains that actually ran through Nashville. The ones on this are the Nashville, Chattanooga, and St. Louis, and underneath that's the Louisville and Nashville. And they ran on a large layout that was in the Children's Museum. Mm-hmm. This is a picture of it here. That station that you saw was on that layout, along with some of the other buildings that we've got in here. The outside portion is the Tennessee Central track. Part of it still exists. The part from here to Monterey still exists. And there's part of it from Nashville to Ashland City that still exists and still is used as a short line.
Después, el guía del Tennessee Central Railway Museum nos presentó la maqueta ferroviaria que tienen en el lugar, así como el área donde se suelen ofrecer charlas informativas. Thank you.
This one is HO scale. It is 1/87 proportion modeled in the prototype. This particular layout is built in sections. It's modular construction. It's put together like dominoes, and on each end there are standards to where the track actually goes. So these can be joined end to end, and so the limit on the size of the layout is only limited by the space that's available. So if you had enough modules, you could fill up this entire room with an HO layout. Each module builder is allowed to do what they want to from here back. Like, there's certain standards for these two tracks here so that they'll meet, you know, so that they will link together. But the rest of it is up to the creativity of the individual modeler. So they will model whatever they feel like. This is a town scene, but right next door to it is a river scene with a gorge and a trestle in the light.
Después de ingresar y recorrer el cabús, fin de tren, el guía nos explicó cómo funciona y cómo se utilizaban cada una de las partes de dicho vagón ferroviario.
Crew members who were responsible for watching the train ahead from the cupola, and if anything went wrong, then they could do what they called dumping the air or flag the end of the train to keep from getting hit by something coming the other way. You need to be careful that if you want to come up here, you can step inside. It's open. These are supplies to flag the end of the train if in an emergency, if they had to make an unexpected stop. Fire extinguisher. Not sure why they had bolts and amp gauges, but this is known as the cupola. the crew members, when the train was in motion, they would climb up here and they would ride in these chairs and they would watch the train ahead. So that if something went wrong, then they could see it and do something about it, either dump all the air or what have you, flag the rear end, stuff like that. It had a kerosene stove to keep warm in the winter. There's a bunk of a sort here, and then there's another desk right here. I'm not sure why they had two of them. This is the laboratory in here, you know, and it was like an office on wheels a long time ago. Conductors had cabooses assigned to them, and so they would fix it up with curtains, and they'd bring food from home and cook it. You can cook on this stove if you want to, or make coffee or what have you. And so they would cook on them, and they'd make food for the rest of the crew and stuff like that. It was, you know, they lived a lot of their life on the railroad, so, you know, they had to have some amenities like that.
Después, en otro coche de la formación ferroviaria del Tennessee Central Railway Museum, el guía nos explicó cómo se podían acomodar los asientos. Luego, recorrí todo el coche.
It's one of our cars that we're really proud of. Amtrak refurbished this one. They refurbished all of them with the carpet that you see, and on the walls also, and up under here. See. And the car would be cool, but, and it's a little warm up here right now because it's a greenhouse, but if you will be careful and watch your step, go up in there and you can see inside the dome itself. Of course, you get a wonderful view of the countryside because you're up high and you're in that solarium, and so you get an excellent view of the countryside, the surrounding countryside. These were really popular, especially in the west, on the Western Pacific, on the California Zephyr. Santa Fe ran them on the Super Chief. Union Pacific had them on their trains going out west. And in later times, there was even a dome car like this one that came through Nashville. As a matter of fact, I rode on it. Nashville had an Amtrak train up until 1979, And it was canceled by then President Jimmy Carter. He is the one that we have to thank for not having Amtrak through Nashville anymore. There has been and is an ongoing effort to bring Amtrak service back.
Agradecemos al personal del Tennessee Central Railway Museum por su cordialidad y la detallada explicación brindada sobre la historia del ferrocarril en Estados Unidos. Para obtener más información sobre el museo, pueden visitar su página web www.tcry.org.